Crater Lake, Oregon, Bigfoot. We did have, what was it, Klamath Falls, I believe. And this is an area that's ripe with Bigfoot reports.
He's retreating into the woods here. Now, you know, you mentioned something about, in an earlier episode, Bigfoot traveling from Canada to Mexico. Now, do they transition through the countryside at different times of year? You mentioned in the wintertime they might do something like that. Do they migrate, or are they just basically stay in one location?
I think they basically stay in one location, but there have been reports of Bigfoot traveling all the way up and down the West Coast from Canada to Mexico.
So I'm wondering if other clans of Bigfoot communicate with each other and also travel and visit each other like a human would visit his family in different areas.
It's entirely possible, and I would think they do it during the winter months. I mean, if you've ever been in any area in California, like, that's desert, you go to Palm Springs during the winter, and it's nice. I mean, it's still kind of hot, but it's not
people travel to Death Valley during the winter time because it's actually, you know, it's reasonable temperatures.
But go there, and Palm Springs, for example, a resort community, go there in the summer, and it's just scorching.
Yeah, it is scorching. It's very hot.
So you couldn't have, even if Bigfoot didn't have a heavy coat of fur, it still wouldn't last very long, just like a human wouldn't last very long.
So Bigfoot travels somewhat like, quote unquote, the snowbirds, you know, from Canada. They come down in the harsh winters from the north into a more tempered climate.
Yeah, and it would be good to get some video of them. Now, there's people on one of these passes. There have been people, there's a regular group of people. What do they call that hike from Canada to Mexico?
Well, that's a Pacific Crest Trail that people travel.
And there's people that have reported on that they've seen Bigfoot along the way. So, I mean, that might be the area they pass from. I mean, if it's smart for people to do it there, it would be smart for Bigfoot.
Well, I mean, hey, I'm sure they know people are traveling on that, and so they're just kind of following that same path. Or is it that Bigfoot's always followed that path, and now, you know, humans are following
it? What time of year do people generally take that path, or is it just any time?
Well, I would assume that they're going to take it in a time when, maybe in the spring, when it's probably the temperatures are mild everywhere.
And they do see Bigfoot around that time, so maybe they both take it around the same time, and Bigfoot takes different trails. Obviously, he's not walking along the main routes.
Bigfoot, you know, is definitely equipped to handle it in the dead of winter, I'm sure.